Okay, for today's class, we are going to deal still with the SQL Server only, and we are going to deal with a new topic, which is the triggers, which is one of the very important TSQL enhancements, which is the management of the flow, whether we are dealing with the DML, the DDL, and even the logon activities from within an SQL Server environment. What is, as a first definition of the trigger, is actually it is a firing event. It is an event caused, let's say, fire. In the sense of, instead of clicking a button, there will be an automated action from the system. Instead of highlighting a statement or something, a command or whatever, there will be an event to cause the automatic action from the system itself. A trigger. This is the theory. This is what we saw in the theory part. We are going to implement triggers, but those triggers, they are going to be segregated into three categories. The first category is related to the management of the manipulation language. This stands here. You know the DML. It's not new for you. We are going to deal with the insert, update, select, alter, delete, all the related queries that they are actually responsible for manipulating data from inside the entities. This is the first group. Because there are constraints here, because there are differences. We are going to see the syntax just in a while. And the second group is to deal with the creation and the alter of the objects, which is a DDL, data definition language, to create an entity, to alter an entity, to let's say drop an entity. This is a context of data definition, and this is a second group of the triggers we are going to manage today. The third, which is actually one third and one segregated also category of the triggers, to control who is allowed to log in and who is not allowed to log into an environment, to a system. We are talking about the SQL Server. Triggers to control the login, the logon action. Yeah, so in the sense of willing to make an insert, we can control. If we're willing to delete a record, we can control that using a trigger. If we're trying to update a value, a field, we can control that. We'll see that just in a while. The same way, if we are trying, for example, to create a new table, a new profile, a new entity, we can control that. If we are willing to alter an entity, we can control that, and so on. If we want to block a user from logging in into an environment, we can control that using the triggers. Syntax, common syntax, the default syntax to all. Here, actually, it is said to be for the DML, but still, there will be definitions that actually similar when we talk about the DDL. We are having the keywords, the TSQL keywords for creating the trigger. Then, after we are having the command type, and then after we have a body for the, let's say, for the replacement or whatever the actual one do. If we're going to make an insert, so instead of the insert, what we are going to do, and so on. So this is the simple syntax for that. Actually, we are seeing it in a brief here. It's not with all the details, but just to make you understand what is the trigger and how it looks like. We'll come to another activity just in after. Let's start with the first implementation of the first DML, just to manipulate the syntax to control like. For this example here, the update. First of all, we are going to create two entities to work with. We are going to create a new database, even. Let's create a new database, which is, let's give it the name geolocalization, or GIS, geolocalization information system. And that has two entities, locations and location history. Let's start with that. Let's start with this. Immediately, SMS. Okay, I'm gonna log in as system admin. Okay, great. I'm in now. Okay, the database we have actually, we have our former database. I want to create a new database. Give it the name PIS, Geolocalization Information System. Here we get it. Tables, we do not have anything. I'm gonna use the Query Builder to create the entities. Actually, I'm gonna use this GIS. Okay. Completed successfully. Good. I am using the JS. Okay, let's start by creating the first entity. The first entity looks like, what is the, yeah, so this is the one. Immediately I'm gonna copy paste. No delay. Where is my interface? Here it is. Minimize the view. Yeah, great. So create table locations, location ID. Okay, the syntax is perfectly correct. Highlight, execute successfully. Refresh the tables. Refresh. Here is my locations. Check the table, the fields. The two fields, yes, exactly. The location ID and the look and name. Yeah. Second entity. Same, highlight, execute, successful. Let me refresh to check up, refresh the tables. We have our second location hist, the second one. Here it is. Great. So now we have our entities ready, so just I'm doing that. Let's create a first trigger. But before of that, let me populate the data inside of any. Let me, because the history will hold the archive, I'm going to use the location to start with. So I'm going to populate the data inside of this one, right-click, display the 200 rows. The first actually location ID, I'm going to say 1, and the location name, I'm going to say Nizwa. For example, next line, I'm going to say 2, location is Muscat. Things like, it's enough. So I have 2 records. There is no save, automatically gets updated. So close. I'm going to select all. I'm going to select stuff from locations. Yeah, from locations. Okay, highlight. Execute. Great. I have the 2 of them now. Yeah, the 2 records. Yeah, the location ID and the location name. Location IDs and the location names. Both of them, they are available to us. Okay, we execute. There is no issue at all. Okay, I'm gonna delete the mascot location. I'm gonna delete the location, the mascot location. Okay. Who am I? I'm the SA. Remember that I'm the system admin, so I can do all. Delete from. What table? Locations. Okay. Locations where. Location ID. Location ID equals to 2. Why 2? Because Muscat, the ID is 2. So I'm going to execute that. Okay. 1 row affected. I'm going to select again. I'm going to select check if it has been truly deleted or not. Yes, it has been deleted. Oh. Okay, can I delete the Nizwa? Let me check. I'm going to execute this one again, first of all, with the same ID too, and see what will happen. It says 0 row affected, means nothing has been deleted. I'm going to change to 1, which is the one is the Nizwa ID. So I'm going to delete the record with 1. Yes, happened, and it says 1 row affected, execute. Yes, nothing is there. I have the fields, but no values. Great. I'm gonna insert again any value here. I'm gonna insert any value. Insert into locations here. Okay, values. Okay, I'm gonna do my parentheses in between here. Locations, I have two fields. The location ID, it's an int. I'm gonna give one. Remember, locations, location ID, it's an int. So I'm gonna give one. Okay, the second field is the lock name, which is a vacha. I'm gonna give it here in between two single quotations. I'm gonna give, for example, here Nizwa. I'm gonna give back the mouse. I'm gonna give a different name. But it's no worry. Actually, it's a string, no more, no less. So, highlight, execute, one row affected. Let me select check the content now. Let me check the content. Yes, he won, and he's back at the mouse. That's good. That's great. So, everything works fine. Great. What we are going to do now? I'm going to control the delete. So. This SA, whether he's actually an admin or whatever, I'm gonna control the delete because the SA can do that later on, can delete the trigger. I'm gonna control the delete or the deletion. This delete here, I'm gonna block it. You remember? I'm gonna insert second one first of all. Let me make it visual to you again. Here I'm gonna say Nizwa. To second position is Nizwa. I'm gonna insert it. Another row has been affected. Let me check again the values again. Highlight, execute. Now I have two records, one and two. One is Beckett Mouse, two is Nizwa. Great. The two, is it deletable? Let me try. Change to two. Highlight. Okay, has been affected one record. Let me check again. Oh yes, it has been deleted. Means now if I change this one to one. And if I execute it, it would delete this number one record. No, I'm gonna create a trigger now. I'm gonna block every try to delete anything from this entity, from the locations. Any trial to delete, we're going to control. How? The triggers can solve that to us. The triggers can solve that to us. Why? Because this delete from locations where lock ID equals to some value, it's a query. It's a DML. The delete is a DML. It's a data manipulation, let's say, query here. We're going to control it. We are not going to allow any deletion from this entity here. Simple. The triggers can do that for us. So I'm going to create a trigger, but I'm going to give it the name. Delete trigger TR. Delete TR. It's user defined. It's user defined. So, what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna create a trigger with a name that I give, I define. I'm defining the name. But this trigger here, this delete TR, it has to have an action on something. The action of this trigger is on the location entity, is on this entity here, on this one. So I'm gonna copy this name to be sure that it is perfectly okay. You can type it whatever on these locations. Okay, so I defined the structure of the trigger. Come on. The trigger, given the name DDTR, would be applied on the entity locations if something happens. For what? For an action. Here we are going to say for delete. For delete. So, for what? The trigger will be launched for every delete trial. Okay. If it would be launched, so there will be actually an action to happen as what? As we have a begin of action and an end of an action, like the procedures we create, actually, like every procedure we create. So here we are going to define something. If the delete has happened on the entity locations, this trigger would be launched, would be fired. So here in between. So here in between, I'm going to do anything actually. See what I want to do. I'm going to write select in between single quotations. Delete is forbidden. On, let me copy paste the name here. Copy paste the name, the same spelling. I'm going to say table. Great. So delete is forbidden on locations table. Very easy. I'm going to highlight. I'm going to check later on why it's highlighted here. Create trigger must be only statement and the batch. Yeah, I know. No worries. So he said that it has to be the unique and the full file. I'm going to highlight it. That's it. Halas. I'm going to execute now. Yes, command completed successfully. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. But see here in these locations, I'm going to expand triggers here. I'm going to expand. And here is what? Delete TR is the same name. The same name is visible now here. Okay. Let me try now. Let me try the delete TR here where it's inside the trigger. And this trigger is inside what? This location's entity. Let's try now. Let's visualize the content of these locations. Select. We have one record. ID is one. ID, location ID or location ID is one. The value is bracket and mouse. Okay. Let's try to delete that value. It has to give us one row affected. So highlight. Execute. No. We have a phrase appear to us. Delete is forbidden on locations table, which is exactly this message. Which is exactly this message. Can I actually, when I executed this delete here again, I'm going to execute. I got this message again. Did it delete? Let's check. Select. Execute. Yes, actually, it has happened, but it has not to do that. Regardless, so I'm going to insert a new value now. Let's say one because we don't have. I'm going to say 10 Muscat. Different IDs, different values. The same location to the same locations I'm inserting. Okay, one row affected. I'm going to insert a new value. I'm going to say 11. I'm going to say Salala. Okay. Highlight, execute another row affected. I'm going to insert number 12. I'm going to say whatever, Hema. Highlight. Great. So I think I inserted three values, three records. Let me check. Select. Yes, we have Muscat, Salala, and Hema here. Three records. Great. And every delete, do I have one here? I don't have one. I'm going to just try to delete. And every delete, actually, this message will be fired. This message would be fired. I'm going to delete the number 10. It would be fired also. Great, great. So now we are clearly capable of controlling the delete. The same way. Like when I did the insert here, I'm going to insert a number 13 record. I'm going to say 101 record ID. The place, for example, let's say whatever, Suhar. I'm going to highlight, execute, happened, one row affected, it says. I'm going to create a trigger to control the insert. So I'm going to leave this one here. I'm going to come back here, a new line, a new block. I'm going to create trigger, give it the name insert TR, on what entity we have the locations only. Locations. I'm going to copy paste. Be sure that the name of the entity is correct. Okay. For what? For the insert. For the insert. Great. We are going to control the insert. We have a body as what? As the beginning here. Begin here and the end. What would come in between those two statements? It would happen here. The insert and the the insert only here. The insert, any insert trial would be actually cause the launch of this trigger. The insert to this location would cause the launch of this trigger. Here we are going to state anything. For example, let me display only a message. Select in between single quotations. You are trying to insert new values. Here I'm gonna give a header to this statement. I'm going to give a header to this statement. See here, I come back here, I come back here, I come back to the here. I'm going to try to delete here. Actually, the delete is controlled. We have a trigger already. I'm going to delete. We had the message. The message is here from here, delete. But what is the header? It's nothing. No colon name, no colon name. I'm going to replace this no colon name with a header. So here, I'm going to, after the single quotation, I'm going to say, as, I'm going to say, for example, alert. A keyword. It's a keyword. It's a user-defined word. Let me execute now. Let me execute. Highlight. Execute. Command executed. Let me now try to insert a new value to this location. So I come back here. Insert. Here is the insert. I'm going to say 102. I'm going to say the place is Dubai. Okay, this is Dubai. Highlight. Let me try to execute. No, we have the alert header. And we have, you are trying to insert new values. There is no. Let me insert number one. I'm going to say Dubai also, the same place. Highlight. Execute. No, alert. You are trying to insert. So we are having, why? Because we are having a new delete TR and we are having a new trigger inside the same table, not only delete. Let me refresh the table here, locations, refresh, triggers, open, expand. Yes, we have two triggers now, the delete and the insert, both of them. Now the insert even is running also. So great. Now this way we are able to control any query that might happen on the selected entity here. Selected entity. What I'm going to do here, I'm going to control any trial to insert a new value to the location. Let me come back to the question because we have to stick to the question itself. So the insertions here create a different trigger that tracks the history, the track of the history here, the track of the history here, how to track. I'm going to insert the history here, track history. Every trial of insert, we are going to insert a value to the history, to the location hist. If we try to insert any value to the location, we have to record that. How? By inserting a new value to the location hist. Location hist, it has location is the location ID plus the modified here date. I'm gonna use it to whatever. I'm gonna insert the date of the day, whatever. Okay, let me go on. So let's create a new trigger. So I'm going to create a new trigger. I'm going to keep everything. So we are going to control the insert again. It's insert. But what we're going to do is to track. If we try to insert, we are not going to display a message. We are going to insert a new value to the location hist. It's not just simple display message. So create new trigger. I'm going to give it the name insert new TR. New. What happened? Insert new TR. Okay, great. On which entity here with the same locations type of locations. Okay, full same insert as we have our body. And then this body now, class, we have our structure for the query now. We have the trigger to be created. We give it a new name, complete new name, the same entity locations, the action to happen on the insert, the body here, we are not going, it's the same so far, but we are not going to do a select. We're going to make an insert, insert into which table? It's location hist. I choose it. What I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna insert into this location hist. And the location is the ID, it would be the same ID of this location. The first value. Location hist has two values. The first one is an int, the second one is a date. I'm gonna change this one actually to be a varchar. I'm gonna change this one to be varchar to avoid the, later on. Let's try now, but later on I'm gonna change it to be a varchar to avoid any syntax errors. So the first value is the ID. This ID I'm gonna bring it from here. It's the same location ID. I'm gonna use the same location ID. So insert into locations hist. I'm gonna say immediately here. Select, I'm not gonna say values. See, I'm saying select this location ID from locations, copy locations, comma, space, the second value, which is this one, modified date. I'm gonna give the date of today immediately. The first value is this one. The location ID is select. The second value is the date of the day. I'm going to say 2021 to respect the syntax. Month 3, date 17. Okay. From, because I'm using the select here, from which ID? From here, from these locations, from locations. Done. I'm finished. I'm going to highlight, execute. Completed successfully. Let me check the content of this hist now. Right click. Edit top 200 rows. It's empty. Let me create a query to select. I'm going to come back here. Select star from location hist here. I'm going to highlight. Execute. Yeah, we have the fields, but they are empty. They are empty. Okay, let me come back now. Actually, did we create the trigger? Let me execute again. Yeah, it has been already exist. Already exist means khalas, we did it. We created. Okay, let's try to insert new values to these locations. Let me come back. Here is the insert. I'm going to say, for example, here number 50, new ID. Place is the say, let's say, Paris, city of Paris, France. Okay, highlight, execute. You are trying to insert new values, and let me check the content of the hist now. See what happened to the hist. It was empty. We have as many records as the records in this location. Everything is tracked. We have the IDs, the same IDs, because we tried, we set, but the same ID from the location will be taken place inside the location hist. The date is the same value. See, the same value I get because I put it in two in between two single quotations. 17 17 17 17 is today's date. It's now, it's exactly what I'm typing here. The time, I did not specify the time because here we set it is date time. It's not date only, it's date time. The time I did not put here time, so it is given 00000. Wonderfully, we are controlling this DMLs. Any questions here, please? Any questions before we continue?
No.
That's great. So Now, perfectly, we are controlling the triggers on the DML side, the first type, the first category, the first category. Let's pass to the second category, which in the first of all, this third trigger, this third, what it is? I want to refresh here. Here it is. It is here. So everything is related to the entity locations because we are linking it to the locations, which is this one. There is another triggers here. It's empty. Nothing is there. Nothing. Refresh. Nothing is there. Nothing. It's empty. There is another trigger here available inside the server, inside the database. Programmability, database triggers. Open. It's empty also. Empty. Empty. Because we did not create anything on the locations list and nothing on the database. We created only DML, DML, data manipulation language, triggers on the locations only, on the locations entity only. Let's create now a DDL, sorry, DDL, DDL trigger, DDL trigger that controls DDL trigger that controls the creation of a new table or the modification of a table. Okay, let's dig in. So I'm gonna create, first of all, I'm gonna launch the command. I'm gonna create a command. I'm gonna implement the command to create, let's say a table, give it the name. Okay. Track walk, track walk, means track to track the walk. Come on, let's be nice and small. Track walk, okay, that's great. So track walk on. That is not on, it's a table here. It's not a figure. Track walk here. And between two single, two parentheses, I'm gonna say TID, it's an int. I'm gonna say T position. Come on, pro position. It's a vacha size 50. Okay, great. Plus, I'm gonna create. So here we have how many entities we have? We have only two. We have only two. The location list and the location. We have two entities. Let me refresh the tables. Only two. Refresh. Only two. Refresh. Refresh. Only two. Wait, let's create this one. Let's execute this this block. Execute. Command created successfully. Let's refresh the tables now. Refresh. We have the third. Here it is. The third has appeared. Great. Means if I create another one, it will happen. It would come to me. I'm gonna create a fourth table. I'm gonna create a fourth table. Give it the name, for example, here, walk two, with the same architecture, just for test only. Execute, has happened. Let me refresh. Oh, here, refresh the tables. Yes, walk. Here it is. Let me delete this. Let me delete this walk. I'm gonna say, up. Up table walk, what's the name? A walking small log. Let me highlight. Execute. Command completed successfully. Let me refresh. We have the walk here. Let me refresh now. Disappeared. Disappeared. It has been deleted. Very great. Very great. Nothing happened here, only execution of command. We are going to forbidden the creation of tables, the drop of tables, and all the let's say other related tasks related to what? Related to the work that has to happen on the database. Create a table where? On the database. On the database. Drop a table from where? From the database. So we're going to do the work on the database now. So the difference in between the DML and the DDL triggers is the on block. also default, but here mainly, see, I'm gonna create the trigger now. Give it the name. Create trigger. It's user defined trigger type for here. Trigger. Yes. Yeah. Okay. TR. Create TR on what? On what? GIS. I'm not gonna type GIS here, but I'm gonna say database. On database. So I'm gonna type it in capital also. Database. See, it's in blue. It's in blue. Means it has been recognized. For what? For what? It's not for create. It's not for create. But for create table. Yes, table. Right? For create table. We do not have create here. So create table. Create. As we have the block here. We have the block here and the end here. Great. In between, we are going to do all what we want. I'm going to just simply display a message for now. Select single quotations. So here in between, I'm gonna specify that I'm forbidden creation of entities is forbidden. I'm gonna give a header to this to this statement as a what? As what? I'm gonna give it yes. DB alert in capital. DB alert. Okay, whatever, it's small, whatever, it's okay. Let me create, so here, remember here in the database triggers, refresh, we have nothing now, nothing. Refresh, open, nothing, it's nothing. Let's create this trigger, which is on the database. Completed successfully, perfect. Let me refresh this block. Here it is, create TR. What is this create here? It's this title here. It's the user defined name here. So perfectly created. How we see that has been read. Let's try to create a new table. Actually, we deleted this walk. Let's create it again. I'm going to highlight, execute. See here, DB alert. Creation of entities is forbidden. Perfectly controlled here. We are not able to create entities on this database. The trigger has been fired, and the statement is shown to us. Is shown, has been shown to us. Okay. Let's talk about this second. Actually, the deletion we did it. But let's just because all the other details, I'm gonna let you do that and you share your screen with me. But let me just give you one last hint. The last hint, actually here. What are the triggers we have in this database on this let's say project? We just select, come on, typo, select. We can specify what to select, but select star from whatever. Here I'm gonna write sys.triggers. Here it is, triggers. Okay, it's enough. I'm gonna select. Okay, we have delete TR, we have insert TR, we have insert new TR, and we have create TR. All of those, we created four triggers where inside of this GIS scene. I'm gonna use students, the other database, students. Go. Okay, I'm gonna highlight, execute. It has been changed to students. Let me execute the same query here. Select star from sys triggers. Execute. We don't have
the same thing. We have something different. TTSS, TTT, those are other works that I did earlier. They are not the same because they are from inside this system here, these students here. I have to come back here, back, use this GIS again, execute, complete successfully. Let me select again the same query, select these triggers, execute. See again, 1, 2, 3, 4, the other triggers we have. So based on the system in, you're specifying your work, the outcome would come to you. Yeah, great. So any questions here, please?